surface of the kidney, you need to draw. And this diagram, that is structure of nephron, the same, you need to draw two diagrams. Ureter, not necessary. Adrenal gland, you need to read. Well, some words about kidney. This diagram only for your understanding. That is a kidney. It has extremitas superior, extremitas inferior, margo medialis, margo lateralis, and two surfaces, anterior and posterior. Medial body has ileum renalis, that is place where ureter, renal artery, and renal vein pass. Internal structure of kidney. Kidney consists of cortex and medulla. Cortex of kidney, that is 5 millimeters on peripheral side of kidney, and medulla has pyramidal structures which continues into calyces renalis minoris. They opens into calyces renalis minoris, lesser calyces. And we have from 9 to 16 pyramids in kidney, and each pyramid together with cortex forms lobe of the kidney. Lobe of the kidney, that is pyramid, one pyramid together with the cortex which attached to pyramid. Lesser calyces renalis minoris join together and forms greater calyces, and greater calyces join together and forms pelvis renalis, and pelvis renalis continues into ureter. Now, that is abdominal wall, here it is lumbar vertebra, that is lumbar vertebra, and that is peritoneum. And kidney is behind of peritoneum in retroperitoneal fat, that is a kidney, left and right kidney. And kidney surrounds with a fascia, that is fascia renalis, and this fascia has anterior and posterior layer. Anterior layer and posterior fuse together laterally from kidney, and medially anterior layer in front of aorta fused with the same layer from opposite side, and posterior layer attached and fused with anterior surface of lumbar vertebra, that is with periosteum of lumbar vertebra. And space between anterior and posterior layer of fascia renalis, it's occupies with a fat tissue. This fat has name capsula adiposa, adipose capsule of kidney. And this fat tissue together with fascia fixed kidney and help to stay kidney on the position. It's very important structures, because if fat reduced, in this case, kidney can descend into true pelvis. It's possible to descend kidney into the pelvis. And what is the main problem in this case? If kidney descend ureter, it makes what? Turn. Will some problems with passage of urine from pelvis renalis into urinary bladder. That is dangerous for human life if kidney descend from normal position. And main structures which help to fix kidney, that is renal fascia and fat tissue, capsula adiposa. Another organs which also help to fix kidney, that is muscular bed of kidney, which consists of musculus transversus abdominis and musculus quadratus lumborum and musculus psoas major. Then intra-abdominal pressure and vessels, that is renal artery, renal vein, and ureter, also participate in fixation of kidney. All of these organs fixed kidney in their position. Now, arteries of the kidney, that is first diagram, what you need to draw. And again, that is a kidney. Here it is aorta, abdominal part of aorta, and that is renal artery. Renal artery in knee of kidney subdivides into three main vessels. They are arteria polaris superior, arteria centralis, and arteria polaris inferior. This artery subdivides into arteria interlobaris, which pass in space between pyramids. Arteria interlobaris. And these arteries on the body between cortex and medulla subdivides into arteria arcuata, and arteria arcuata makes anastomosis one with another. It is arteria arcuata which makes anastomosis. And from arteria arcuata start arteria interlobularis, which goes to cortex of kidney. And from arteria interlobularis start arteriola afferens. It goes to glomerulus, that is networks of capillaries. And from glomerulus start arteriola efferens. All of them are arteries of the kidney, and this network, glomerulus, network of capillaries between two arteries, that is miracle network of kidney. One again, number one, that is aorta abdominalis, number two, renal artery, number three, arteria polaris superior, number four, arteria centralis, number five, arteria polaris inferior, number six, they are arteria interlobaris, number seven, arteria arcuata, number eight, arteria interlobularis, number nine, that is arteriola afferens, 10, that is glomerulus, and 11, arteriola efferens. They are arteries of the kidney. And now, structure of nephron. One again, we start from arteria interlobularis, that is arteria interlobularis. At this diagram, it is number H. Here it is arteriola afferens, and here it is glomerulus. Glomerulus surrounds with capsule of nephron, Bowman's capsule. And from Bowman's capsule start proximal convoluted tube. It continues to Strauss tube, tubuli renalis recti. It makes a Henle's loop. Then distal convoluted tube. Then junctional part. And collecting tube. But collecting tube, it is not part of nephron. Last part of nephron, that is junctional part. Number one, that is arteria interlobularis. Number two, arteriola afferens. Number three, glomerulus. Number four, arteriola efferens. And this arteriola continues into secondary capillary network. Number five, that is capsule of nephron. Bowman's capsule, and together glomerulus and Bowman's capsule, number three and number five together, that is corpusculum renalis. Corpusculum renalis consists of glomerulus and Bowman's capsule. Number seven, that is proximal convoluted tube. Number eight, tubuli renalis recti. They make Henle's loop, number nine, or Anza nephroni, Henle's loop. Distal convoluted tube number 10, junctional part number 11, and collecting tubes number 12. these two diagrams you need to draw next time. Now the same only for your understanding. I continue to draw that collecting tubes goes to the apex of pyramid, and that is calyces renalis minoris, lesser calyces, and that is collecting tubes. They join together and makes ducts, ductuli papillaris, papillary ducts. A lot of papillary ducts opens into the apex of pyramid. Ductuli papillaris opens into the calyces renalis minoris on the apex of pyramid. And here it is, we can see fornix of lesser calyces. And in the region of fornix, we have some structures which help to discharge urine into these calyces. And main muscle here it is, that is musculus sphincter fornicis. Musculus sphincter fornicis, that is main muscle in this region. Musculus sphincter fornicis. This muscle, it press apex of pyramid, and in this case, urine goes to calyces renalis minoris. Another muscle, it's expand this fornix, that is musculus levator fornicis. It's dilate this apex, and urine go to through ductuli papillaris goes to the apex. Then one again, musculus sphincter press it, and urine discharge into calyces renalis minoris. Another additional muscle, that is spiral muscle of calyces, musculus spiralis calyces. And last muscle is musculus longitudinalis calyces. They help to continue conduct urine into calyces renalis majoris. That is why fornical apparate, that is complex of structures in the region of calyces renalis minoris, which consists of main muscle, that is musculus sphincter fornicis, and three additional muscles, levator fornicis, spiralis calyces, and longitudinalis calyces. Together with vessels and nerves, all of these structures helps to discharge urine into calyces renalis minoris and then conduct it into the calyces renalis majoris. That is fornical apparate. And some words about adrenal gland. Adrenal gland, it's situated above of kidney, consists of cortex and medulla. Medulla of adrenal gland produced adrenaline and noradrenaline, and cortex produces three types of steroid hormones. Glucocorticoids, that is cortisone or hydrocortisone, then mineralocorticoids, that is aldosterone, and sex hormones, testosterone, that is male sex hormone or androgen, and estrogens, that is estrone or estradiol, both of them, male and female sex hormones produced in everybody, in male and in female. I think you know that main organ which produces sex hormone in male, that is testis, in female, that is ovary. But additional gland where the same produce testosterone and estrogens, that is adrenal gland or suprarenal gland. Have you got any questions? What we can see? Have you got forceps? Well, not necessary to do that. We try to see without forceps. But next time I ask you to receive forceps before our classes.